Good day, everyone. Today, we will be learning about peer reviewing. I hope you're ready. Now let's get started. Exchanging papers with a classmate, reading each other's paper, and making comments are called peer reviewing. Peer reviewing is done not because your teacher is too busy to read all the students' papers, nor are you a better writer than your classmate, but peer reviewing is done because you can learn a lot by reading your classmate's work. When you read a classmate's paper, you can practice finding topic sentences, supporting sentences, and concluding sentences. Notice special vocabulary or grammar. See different ways to do the same assignment. Help the writer by saying what ideas you like best. Ask questions to help the writer think of more ideas. Or ask a question if you don't understand something, and maybe the writer will think of a better way to explain it. Many writers, even very good writers, feel nervous or shy about sharing their writing. But peer reviewing is really beneficial to writers. Make sure, though, that when you write comments about someone's writing, be kind, useful, and truthful. Remember always to say what you like, but it should be something that will improve your classmates' work. Comment on ideas and organization, and not spelling or grammar. Now, let's try picking out the kinds of comments that would be useful for the writer. For not useful comments, give a reason like, it isn't kind, it isn't clear, it isn't useful, or it probably isn't true. Letter A is a polite comment to say that the topic sentence is good and approved. Letter B can be a comment to improve your classmate's work, but it is not politely presented, so it isn't kind. Letter C is a good comment because it is polite and clear, and letter D and E are both useful comments. Saying, I think it's okay, isn't clear nor useful. Letter G is a bad comment. It isn't kind, isn't clear, nor useful. Letter H is a useful review by giving a positive, honest comment. So make sure when you give a positive comment, you don't only say it's good or okay, but you also give a specific point on what it is you like in the work so that it will be a valid and useful comment. Letter I is another example of a valid, positive review. Letter J isn't useful because it doesn't give a specific point how the writer could be better than Shakespeare, while the last comment is useful. Peer reviewing doesn't only help you to be a good help to your classmate, but it will also help you to be a better writer on how others take your work. Just remember, when you give your comments, either positive or negative, make sure they are kind, clear, useful, and true. And that's it on what is peer reviewing and how to properly do it. I hope you had fun and learned from this lesson. Thank you for watching.